time for us to get into the meditation. One main tip: trust in your intelligence. This experience, this learning, this listening, this meditating will create intelligence in you. This bliss will awaken intelligence in you. Trust that intelligence, because for you I will give some tips that will not be useful for the other. Tips means you are asking do's and don'ts. Do's and don'ts can never be created for a group. Always it has to be individual. I can tell you the overall few do's and don'ts. From the first body, if you pick up, eat the right food, the purity of food. Next thing, eat with the right mood. Next, try to avoid, minimize the sleeping hours. Find out whether you are Chandramani or Sauramani, decrease the time so that the quality will improve. If the quality of sleep improves, the quality of awareness will improve. Small, small tips, whatever you heard from day for yesterday onwards, try to imbibe over. Try to imbibe bit by bit, bit by bit. That's enough. Otherwise, I don't have any idea how to give you tips. I can give only intelligence. You make it into tips. Reduce the time. Reduce the quantity. Automatically quality will improve. Don't believe your mind. Just reduce the time. Now if you are, how many hours you are sleeping now?
7 hours.
Reduce it to 4 hours. Just simply reduce. Actually, in the NSP, I am giving like this Rudrakshamuni in America. But I am not telling the people to wear. I am not telling them to wear regularly. But in America, people asked, Swamiji, can we wear regularly? I said, you are welcome. See, if you are ready not to bother about the society, it is up to you. One thing, if you continuously bother about society, are they going to come when you leave the body? It is your aloneness. It is your thing. And one more thing. You are bothering about that fellows and that fellows are bothering about you. One more thing, be very clear. Mass never pulls you down. Your unconscious mental setup which gives mass as a reason. Be very clear. Mass never disturbs you. One thing, when you are satisfied, when you have food and clothes, shelter, everything, self-satisfied, how can anybody disturb you in your life? Tell me. See, one thing, in the society, now the society has become so modern, people are ready to understand the individual aspects. There are so many people, they live one day and live their life. You see, when hippies can manage, can't you manage? You are not so against society like hippies. When hippies can manage, can't you? Tell me, it is your courage. It is your courage. One more thing, unless you integrate yourself, you cannot. You will be having the same problem continuously. When are you going to integrate yourself? When are you going to decide? Either some one time you have to say no. Are you going to say no after 60 years old? Or now itself, decide. But no, you have to say no. One thing, there is a saying. Genius are the people who became genius in spite of society. In spite of mass. Who are courageous enough to say no to the society. Genius means nothing but saying no to the society. How long you are going to say yes to the society? It's like a flattened rice when you put it in the water. Like that only we are living. Our personality is no integration. The problem is, only when everybody accepts and gives you the rubber stamp, you feel good. Ah, yes, I am doing right. Then how can you expect everyone will accept and give you the rubber stamp? If everyone accepts and gives you the rubber stamp, don't follow that. Now again it has become one more tradition. It cannot give you the truth. So be very clear, it is the path of aloneness. You have to travel only alone. The society can give you only a small service of pulling you back. That's all. You cannot expect anything else from society. How can you expect? And why should you expect? See, society has got its own invested interest. If you are working for its good, it will help you in all the way. But you are not working for society, you are working for yourself. Then don't mind your business, go and work as society has. Be in fear, be in greed, you see. Once a man is liberated from fear and greed, he will not bother society. You will not bother. Nothing can carry you. You will not be once you do all this meditation, you will not care for any other Swami. I know. Because you know much more than them. So naturally, you will not care for them. You will not care for any politician. You will not care for any priest, politician, the social, so-called social, well-to-do people. You will not care for a rich guy. Because you will not be running behind his wealth. You will not care for anybody. Then why should they care for you? Why should they respect you? Why should they give you their rubber stamp? They will not. It's a mutual contract. When you care for them, they care for you. But here, once you draw from all these things, once you start meditating deeply, naturally you don't care for them. Then what to do? So, why do you expect the society's acknowledgement, a society's rubber stamp? Why are you so weak? One thing, when I say don't care, I am telling only about the spiritual way. Don't let them not disturb your spiritual growth. I am not telling go and fight with them. And one more thing, when I say don't care, let them not interfere in your lifestyle. Otherwise, all social reasons that you be with them, you have to be with them, you are going to be with them. I am not telling in that way. I am telling you about the practical day-to-day life. Let them not interfere in your meditation, let them not interfere. You are telling something that people will sleep. People will think that I have become crazy. Let them think, what is there? If you sleep less, who is going to be affected? Nobody. Nobody. No, if you sleep more only, you will create some sound and there will be disturbance. They will be affected. If you sleep less, how can they be affected? Tell me. Mine is Chandramana. Even till 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, you will see that I will be jumping around. But early morning, I always rest. Even programs you can see, early morning there will be no programs. No program will be given early morning. Of course, now you have to work on this mantra, tantra. I'm coming every day, early morning. Actually, Chandramana, Savramana, both the time you are not working. Chandramana means 10 to 12. Savramana means 6 to, around 4:30 to 6. Both the time you are not sleeping. Both the time you are not working. I'm telling you, you see, apart from 8 hours of work, the whole other day is in your hand. In your hand. But one more thing, if you are a Chandramani, if you are a Savramani, try to avoid night shifts. If you are a, what to say, if you are a Savramani, you have to sleep in the night time. Try to avoid night shift, change the job, no other way. We have to do some changes also in the outside world, no other way.
But Chandramani, the whole world works only in the daytime, how will you adjust their lifestyle?
Because nature does not believe in society. Society does not believe in nature, what to do? So you want nature or society, it is up to you to decide. That's why so much of cancer, so much of eye problems, so much of the internal conflicts. Understand, even the depression and internal conflicts are from causal body only. Because if the causal body is not let to sleep, rest, let to work, naturally you will have whole day tamas. Whole day. Your own experience you can decide. Just try for 3 days. First, try for 3 days avoiding sleeping in the night. Try for 3 days avoiding sleeping in the daytime, the early morning. Which feels more comfortable? It's your mana, that's all. If you feel uncomfortable, both avamana. Your avamana, you have a wonderful chance, you can choose any one mana. And then avoid the other mana. Train yourself, over. If you have a choice, choose always Chandramana. Choose always Chandramana. Because sun regenerates you more quickly. Sun energizes you more quickly. At that time if you rest, the energizing process is more quick. But if you don't have choice, don't worry. It's time for us to enter into mantra, tantra and yantra. Let me explain what is yantra. There is a thing called art therapy. You must have heard already about this. How many of you don't know about art therapy? Oh, so many. Okay. Let me explain. There is a research done by these people, mental doctors. They give canvas cloth and the paint to the mental patients, and they are asked to paint wildly. This way, that way, how the mad people will paint, you know. People are in chaotic mind. People start enjoying chaos. That is why even the movies you see, wild terrorist movies, they are becoming popular. Whatever the chaotic things, wild things you start enjoying, your choice has become like a satanic. Your choice has become devilish, destroying, death worshipping, not even death worshipping, destruction worshipping, negative. That is why they start enjoying. Anyhow, like a mad people, they paint like a mad people. Really like mad people. The beauty is, after 21 days of painting, the madness comes down. Because the catharsis happens, they throw the things out. And one more strange thing, whomsoever became mad because of money, they all paint in the same way. Whomsoever became mad because of women, they all paint in the same way. Whomsoever became mad because of name and fame, they all paint in a same way. And the doctors, 2-3 doctors who are doing deep research on this phenomena, they became mad. The whole thing has to be understood. Two things you have to understand. First thing, they express what is their experience. Next thing, if you deeply concentrate on the expression, you reach the same experience. Understand these two factors. They express what is their experience. If you deeply meditate on the expression, you reach the same experience. Yantras are the expressions of enlightenment. Masters who became enlightened, they put some diagrams, they put some painting, they express their enlightenment. That is what is yantras. Yantra means forms. When Markandeya became enlightened, he made a painting. That is what is called Rajarajeshwari. When Sukhabrahma became enlightened, he made a painting. That is what we call Dakshinamurti. So everybody expresses their enlightenment in a symbolic way, metaphysical way. That is what we call yantras. When you meditate on that yantra, when you relate on that yantra, you reach the same experience. Because unless you understand this concept, you will not be able to enter into the meditation. So if you relate with the yantra, same effect, same experience is created in you. Let me explain the yantra of this Dakshinamurti. The Rakshas who is under his feet is ego. He has destroyed the ego. And the Chinmudra is a blessing, is the Anugraha Shakti. And the fire in the damaru means the drum in the right hand, is the Srishti, vibrations. From vibration only the whole world came out, Srishti. And the fire in the left hand is the destruction. See, Srishti, Stiri, destruction, Laya. And this is the intelligence, wisdom. The book is the wisdom. This is the metaphysical representation of divine energy or meditative energy. The energy which is called meditation. Why is doing Srishti, Stiti, Laya? Creating, maintaining and destroying. He destroys your past birth. You die as a past being. You are taking birth as a new being. He gives you the new birth. And he maintains you. That is why Guru Brahma, he gives birth. Guru Vishnu, he maintains you. Guru Maheshwara, he destroys your past. That is the symbol shown through this tantra. The meditative energy, the divine energy expressed is through this yantra. Now we are going to work on the mantra which is Om, white light. To represent, to make you remember. Cosmic question. Only you have purpose for anything and everything because you want some goal. God doesn't want any goal to be achieved. He is enough unto himself. If you ask why, there is no reason. First thing, You are asking, you see, understand, your aunt is asking, your elephant, why are you not wearing any cloth? Can elephant answer? The very question of the ant will not reach the elephant. The space in which the creation is happening, in that space your logic cannot reach at all. The question is rising from your logic, which is very, very, very low level. For this question, you cannot answer from the level of creation. I can answer just to give you all intelligence, but I will not be convinced. Answer for this question cannot be given as a logic. It can be given only as an experience. Only when you experience the insider view, you will understand the whole thing is just Leela. Energy, floating in the energy. There is no reason. There cannot be why. Because your why is in a, like ant's question. Ant's question can never be answered by elephant. Exist, Why the creation? So the ant is different. Ant's logic can never reach the elephant. Our logic never reaches the space of creation. Because once you become a little more matured, all this logic disappears. In the young age, you had a lot of questions. Now all these things are slowly, slowly disappeared. It will disappear.